Hi, y'all. So I'm going to be telling you all about a fascinating tool that has become very present part of my life, despite the fact that I have never actually touched or used it. And this tool is Kubernetes. I don't know if you've ever heard of Kubernetes before. I hear about it a lot from someone named Ian Coldwater. We met because they're my mom. And you know, they talk about it quite a bit. So because of this, you would think that I understand what Kubernetes is. I don't. And I have been explained, it has been explained to me, actually, quite a bit from a lot of different people. I understand that there are a lot of words connected to Kubernetes. There is containers, there are nodes, there are clusters, there are virtual machines. I don't really know how they go together, but I know they're important. Specifically, I would like to talk about containers for a second. If Kubernetes' whole thing is that you have to put small things inside of other small things, then why is the thing you put the stuff into not the container? That's my main question. But anyways, as adults in my life at tech conferences tried to explain to me what Kubernetes is, I have found that they often use a lot of metaphors. And a lot of them are a wide variety of helpful or not helpful. This one is a fave of mine from Kaslin Rocks. This one is telling me that my computer is a cereal or a cookie bowl and that my cookie is a container. That's confusing. Why is the bowl not the container? There was one time that I asked Twitter to tell me what Kubernetes was, and if we could just take a moment to just look at these answers. Because, my goodness. Y'all okay? Another one of my favorite resources, and maybe the most explanatory one, was the Children's Guide to Kubernetes. And it was about a whole bunch of, or one giraffe who got adopted by a bunch of pirates and then duplicated himself and learned a life lesson about friendship and stuff. But the most important one was, of course, Burgernetes. This is. Anyways, so none of those were actually super helpful in explaining what Kubernetes was. Like, I don't know if y'all got that. So I was really just curious if there was any information in the world that could tell me how I could use Kubernetes, what it actually is. And so I decided that I was going to start looking for some like hard-hitting technical documentation, maybe some diagrams, and then maybe that could like explain it better. So I found this one. Super helpful. Now I know it is five whales. Maybe there are some more on Google Images. This one, you know, from the looks of it, looks fairly similar to actually a lot of things I've been seeing on these slides in the last 6 hours. Why are there minions? What does that mean? I'm not quite sure. And this one is one of my fave. This means nothing. This is garbage. Why are there turtles? I think the turtles actually replicated themselves, and the Kubernetes army is putting them together with the giraffes. But who could forget about the Cloud Native Computing Foundation's famous landscape? This one is a complicated puzzle. I know this because once I actually did a 1,000-piece puzzle with this, in which each of these fit onto their own piece. It was a mess. So, a long story short, Mom, what is it that you do every day? This was my main question that led to this talk. What is a Kubernetes? How do you make a Kubernetes? Where does it go? What is it made of? What actually is it? My mom responded, well, you know how I'm always complaining about YAML? I'm like, I guess. What's YAML? And to which they looked me in the eye and they said, well, Nara, YAML is just JSON files, but without commas. And I said, you spend all your time in a JSON file? Like, all of your time. I am genuinely concerned for your well-being. You, audience, I'm also concerned for your well-being. I hope that you are doing well and taking care of yourself. Thank you.